Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here, and welcome to the channel. Today we're going to talk about step climbs. We're here in the Fenix Airbus 320 in Microsoft Flight Simulator, and we've got a flight plan inserted which takes us from London Luton all the way down to Cairo, so a long route today, and one where we would expect to see step climbs occur. Typically we don't see step climb activity on short sectors because it's not so efficient to put the energy into climbing higher and higher on such short routes. So typically you'll see this on the longer sectors. There are variances to that, and it could be due to air traffic control restrictions and so forth. There are generally two types of step climb. We've got the climbs where we're looking to get to our optimal flight levels, and we've also got geographical or air traffic control restrictions, which we'd look to achieve a certain flight level at a particular point on the flight plan. The general reasons why we would step climb on routes, perhaps our flight planners calculated our cruise to be below optimal initially due to an air traffic control restriction, due to the airspace we're passing through, and then later on, once that airspace is behind us, we may be then cleared to climb up higher and higher. So we'd use step climbs in that instance. Again, as today, we've got a long route, we're carrying a lot of fuel. As we progress through the flight, the aircraft can become lighter. Our optimal flight levels will become higher and higher as we go on, and efficiency is gained by climbing. So we'd use step climbs on route as well for that. Also, we'd have differing winds aloft. So, you know, compared to the forecast winds, we might actually climb up. It's unusual these days due to forecast accuracy. It's pretty accurate, but we may get up there and there'll be something totally different and happening with the wind, and you know, we may request spot wind checks from our aircraft in the vicinity and determine whether actually we need to step climb up or even down to get into a better wind situation. We also may have air traffic control requests due to traffic flow. They may want us at a particular altitude at a particular point just due to the density of traffic, and that's quite common. So, in terms of our flight today, in the flight plan, we're currently planned to start at 33,000 feet, flight level 330, but we've got a geographical climb here put into the point at Bigar at 350. We can also check our optimal flight plan, our optimal flight level here is 310 currently. Gonna go above that, our maximum achievable at the moment is 34.5, and that will climb up as we burn fuel off. So to insert a step climb, you come to flight plan page and you'd right select on one of the waypoints, and you go to step alts. So as it says here, if you just want the optimal step to be forecast en route, and you can just put your altitude in the 350 in here, and it will just tell you with an uptick on the map where in the route you'll get to that optimal point where you need to climb. Today we've been given a restriction of 350, so it's a geographical restriction at Bigar. We also put the name of the waypoint in as well, so it would instruct us to climb at that particular point. So we'd insert that into the flight plan, and we can go and have a look, see where that is en route. Get down there. Right, there we go. So between Bigar and Tango Romeo Alpha, it's now put the step climb into that position. So as we get there, across that point, it won't automatically climb. The same way the aircraft or the Airbus doesn't descend when you reach top of climb, or top of descent, sorry. We do have to get in touch with air traffic control, say, look, we'd like further climb, please, up to flight level 350. We'll get that clearance. We'll adjust the altitude in the FCU window, and we'd climb very slowly using vertical speed of perhaps 300 feet, so a slow climb up, and that will adjust automatically the new cruise flight level in the MCDU, and that's how we'd achieve a flight level change and a step altitude change. So it's just nothing physically happens unless you alter it in the FCU and make that change, but obviously we need to be informing air traffic control. And making that manual change ourselves. So it provides guidance and it shows us where we should be making those changes on the navigation display once we put the information into the box. But yeah, it's very much a case of just giving that visual aid on routes as to where we can make climbs or even descents. It's important to remember that if we don't get the climb at that particular point, we pass that, it will clear the step climb out. And if we make any lateral revisions, so if we took the waypoint big R out, for example, due to a change, we deleted that, it will also delete the step altitude change that we put in as well. That's just important to remember that. So that's how you put in your step altitudes. Again, so it's flight plan, right select one of the waypoint keys and go into your step altitude page. Again, if you wanted just to put in a clear that one out, come back in, step out. If you just wanted to understand where on the route the most optimal point would be to get to 350, because it might not necessarily be at Bigar, that might be an ATC restriction and we have to make that climb at that point. If we just wanted to know for information where that is and remind us that we can achieve 350 at that point, we'd just put 350 in, and then it's not a waypoint, it's just the optimal point on the flight plan. It'll insert, and we'll just insert that, and that will display on the map if it's achievable. So that's step climbs. I hope you found that useful. Any questions on that, drop them in chat and I'll do my best to answer them. Please like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.